Well, hello, I'm Chip Jones, and as you can tell, we're not at Okarga Farms today. We're actually in downtown Broken Arrow. We're right here on Main Street. It's also known as the Rose District, and I wanted to bring you down and show you a little bit of this area. This is a great community for families. It's actually been awarded number 11 on the top 50 best places to live in the country, and I am so now glad to call this small town America home. As we're going to go walking around today, I wanted to show you examples of what civic pride can do. You know, this was a typical downtown area in the 1970s and 80s. It had really gone to the wayside. No one was moving in. And a group of citizens decided to get together and start sprucing up this area block by block. Part of that was actually bringing back roses. You know, roses have been around for many, many years, and when settlers came to the prairie, they found absolutely no types of trees, shrubs, or flowers to be had. So back then, a small group of residences got together and decided to, you know, start bringing in plants just to kind of soften the prairie feel. And slowly, one by one, roses actually became the mainstay of the plantings here in Broken Arrow. Then as tourists began to travel, especially during the 30s, this area became known as the City of Roses. And in time, roses lost their popularity in this area, and many people just forgot all about that history. So then in the late 90s, early 2000s, there was a group of citizens who decided to get together. They knew about that history, and they wanted to actually bring back the roses. And this area actually flourished just from that initial start of wanting to grow a simple plant that brought back the sound of history to residents here in Broken Arrow. So what we're going to do is we're going to walk around. I'm going to show you at what all of that civic pride has done to this area. Now this is a bustling small town here in Northeast Oklahoma, and I just want to show you what life is like on a typical Saturday morning here in the summertime. We're going to walk to the farmer's market, we're going to walk through and look at all the roses, and then at the end we'll come back and I'll give you a recap of what we've seen. Again, I just want to show you a little bit of what life is like here in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. And as you can tell, as you walk along Main Street here in Broken Arrow, there are so many people have jumped on that civic pride of planting flowers and trees and turning this into really a green oasis here in Northeast Oklahoma. As you look here at the side of this bank, they have been planting some wonderful plants to sustain the heat of the summer. You have the pintas that are up front, of course, liriope, nandina. And then just look at these beautiful hostas. Again, you wouldn't always think of planting hostas in more of a commercial type of location, but these being on the east side of the building and protected from that western side of the heat, these should stay beautiful and lush all summer long. As you walk through the Main Street area, there are just more and more layers of color. So we're gonna walk down Main Street now and just show you a little bit about what you'll find when you visit this great small town. I wanted to be sure and bring you by one of my favorite stops here in the Rose District in Broken Arrow. It's at this umbrella catalpa tree. It was actually planted here, they believe, around 1900 as one of the first trees that was actually in this area. You know, the settlers were told to bring in a few plants to kind of help settle the prairie and provide shade and sustenance for the area. And by planting this catalpa tree, not only did this tree provide a great amount of shade, But because of the type of tree it is, it attracted worms, which were then collected and used for fishing in the creeks and rivers, so the settlers could then catch fish and use that for their food. So as you can imagine, with all the storms that have blown in across the prairie, this tree has seen many heavy winds, many summers of drought, and many days of heavy rain. But it's still here, again, originally thought to be planted in 1900, and I hope that we will see trees like this preserved and saved so that we all remember the history of what this area was once like around the turn of the century. Getting involved even in small projects in your community is very important. You know, we all must participate in our communities if we want them to survive. And this is just one example of a project that I got involved in here in Broken Arrow. This is a Monarch Way station that is just off of the main street here in the Rose District. And it's also next to the playground where kids can come and play. A group of us all worked together to donate different parts of our businesses to make this project come together. Of course, working at Sanders Nursery, it was very important for us to be able to donate the plants. And I think this great small project has been a great way for young members of the community can come. They can come over and play, and then they can learn about monarchs and different types of plants that they need if they're going to have a pollinator garden at their home. So again, this is a great project that I am so proud to be a part of. And I hope it's a project that will be here for many years to come. And just look, here we are. Imagine what this is. This is the future Broken Arrow Rose Garden that is coming here to the Rose District. And this is something that I'm so excited and passionate about. The Bring Back the Roses campaign has been working toward this for many years, as well as the Keep Broken Arrow Beautiful campaign. And just in a couple of months, I do believe that we're going to start breaking ground on this new garden that's going to be here and will be part of Central Park here in Broken Arrow's Rose District. As the park starts to come together, I hope to bring you some updates as we are hoping to become involved in this project. It's not only going to be a rose garden, I think there are going to be all types of different kinds of plants certainly being added, and I think it's going to be a great new part of this park as it comes to life and really starts to come to bloom. So in the future, I hope to be bringing you some more updates, but I just couldn't stop by because I wanted you to just see what this has started out to be so that we'll have those before shots, and then hopefully you can come along with me as we watch this project grow. Again, this is the future Broken Arrow Rose Garden coming to the Rose District here soon. So as you can tell, there's always a lot going on here in the Rose District in Broken Arrow, but I didn't want to finish this tour without stopping by here at the Broken Arrow Performing Arts Center. It's also the home to the Kristen Chenoweth Broadway Boot Camp every summer, as Kristen Chenoweth was a resident who grew up here in Broken Arrow before she went on to stardom in Broadway and across the world. And I hope you've enjoyed this little mini tour of the place that I call home here in Broken Arrow. Has certainly been a great landing spot and a place that we are so happy to call home. But we're going to finish things up here. We're going to head back out to the farm because we've got some planting to do. And remember, if you liked this video, be sure to subscribe, like, and follow me, the Preppy Gardener, and I'll see you in the next video.